Very welcome back inside our Proactive Newsroom. And joining me now is Mike Garbutt. He is the COO of Clean Air Metals. And Mike, it's good to see you. How are you?
I'm good. How are you, Steve?
I'm doing well, doing well. Thought it'd be a great opportunity to get a bit of an update on what's going on. We had your CEO, Jim Gallagher, on recently. He talked about sort of what the strategy was for 2024 for Clean Air Metals. And the key component was the downplunge exploration at Escape. So thought maybe a good opportunity to give us a bit of insight into that, a bit of an update on what's going on, and just the progress you're seeing.
Yeah, sounds good, Steve. So our team is excited to build upon the resource at the Thunder Bay North project. And this target we see is the extension of one of our deposits, the Escape deposit. And it's about a 2.5 kilometer strike, is about at a depth of about 500 meters below surface, and is just on the other side of a structure we call the Escape fault, which was an older pre-existing fault. The reason they're excited is for two reasons. It's a magnetic anomaly, fairly strong, and it's continuous right from the Escape Lake, the Escape deposit, which hosts a 6 million ton resource. It's continuous for 2.5 kilometers, and it's largely untested, particularly on the other side of this Escape fault. The second thing is we believe it's the right geology. If we extend our geology, the red hybrids and the peridotites from our last known hole, this magnetic anomaly lines up perfectly with this geology. So we're excited to get going on that. What we're doing right now, where we have some people in doing what's called a constraint inversion. And what that's going to do is help us better define that target. And then we're going to follow that up with a modest drill program. It's going to be a few holes with some downhole EM, which, that technique actually worked well up at the Escape deposit, where if we do downhole EM, we can see the high-grade escape zone from about 300 meters away. So we believe we have the right technology to define something there. We're excited to get going. It looks like we're probably going to be starting sometime in the summer, and the team's excited to grow that resource.
Yeah, and that's, I guess, what you really want people to understand is that there's a lot of behind-the-scenes work that's getting ready for certain questions that need to be answered. And this had been sort of all along that you were needed to answer those questions. So I guess that's the message here, is that you're sort of following in on what you've been talking about for the last couple of years.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, the last couple of years, we have been focused on growing the resource at Escape and the current deposit, and we have a 14 million ton resource right now. This downhole extension, the magnetic response, has been known for a while, just we've never followed up on it. And with some more recent work, we've looked at, it actually looks like something that could be add value to the asset.
Absolutely. Let's talk about a bit more of your 2024 strategy, and that was the opportunities in Northwestern Ontario. So can you talk to me a little bit about what's there, and more importantly, what you're sort of doing and how the road looks ahead?
Yeah, for sure. So, I will say we're always looking at opportunities to grow if possible, but right now we're a little more focused, and we're casting a little bit of a wider net on evaluating these properties, and really focused on prospective PGE assets, because that's our sweet spot, and we believe in the long term vision for platinum and palladium. So the opportunity is to add to our portfolio, and it's not growth for the sake of growth. It's what we want to do is create value for shareholders and really find some of those gems out there. So, and it is the right time. Where we are right now, we've started in February, and there's some interesting assets out there, and I won't obviously mention any names, but we see things like a claims package held by prospectors that is with grab samples and surface showings at 6 grams per ton platinum palladium that is relatively immature from an exploration standpoint and can use some actual exploration technology. We see more mature exploration assets that have a smaller resource, 1 to 2 million tons, but with a lot of unanswered questions, and we think we have the team that could go in and figure out things and look at it a little differently and maybe answer some of those questions and grow that resource. And then finally, we've seen we've seen past producers that are sitting there with 5-6 million ton resource, 43-101 compliant, that actually just need some market conditions to improve to make sense. And this is kind of an opportunistic time to really get in there. So yeah, we believe it's the right time to do this. There are a lot of opportunities out there. We're in the middle of it right now, but we don't want to rush into it. We want to do our homework before we move forward.
Yeah, slow and steady. Definitely the way things are going with the markets. It's a great, great philosophy to have for sure. Mike, thanks so much. Great to catch up with you and see what's going on with the company. And we'll talk again soon, okay?
All right. Thanks, Steve.
All right. There's Mike Garbutt, the COO of Clean Air Metals.